With us now is Stephen Murphy, the Murph. Hello.
Hello, Donna. Hello. How are you?
I'm so well. So there is the Murphs, right? And cooking with the Murph and living it up with the Murph and partying with the Murph. But here you have a beautiful display.
Of course. What we have here is a display of different uses of the Murph with different alcohols. You know, we have a little bit of a COVID situation. We think there's a a cure coming, a medication coming, but people want to get creative as if they have to go back into hiding per se.
Yep.
So I'm just going to provide different ideas because a traditional Bloody Mary, which is right here, Donna, is made with vodka. And anybody who drinks Bloody Marys would say, hey, you know, I what vodka do you use? But there are other uses of alcohol with Bloody Marys and preferably Murphs.
There you go.
So this is your traditional Bloody Mary. What I did is I dressed it up because I know, Donna, you like.
I like things that are pretty.
Yes.
Things that are pretty and things that taste good.
Yes.
Okay.
So that's Murphs with vodka. Whichever vodka you choose is really up to you. Murphs goes good with every vodka, but that's your traditional Bloody Mary.
Okay, and Murphs comes in just regular, the original, and also hot and spicy and woo-hoo-hoo.
Correct. Here's your hot and spicy.
Right.
Here's your original.
There you go. Okay.
Yes. All natural, no preservatives. Okay.
Really great product. I mean, seriously, the nicest thing about your product, Stephen, is the fact that the ingredients are really fresh and it's made really well.
Yeah.
And that, I mean, that's the basis. I just drink it straight, but go ahead and tell me how you're dressing it up today.
Okay. Well, we do make it like Sunday sauce. We start with water and tomato paste and then and cook it up for 45 minutes. So it's sort of like, you know, we take our time cooking it.
There's love in it.
You're loving it. Much love. Family love.
Okay.
So, Donna, this is a tequila, okay, which is a very, very popular drink that people are trying to find new ways to drink tequila. But what people don't realize, and I get a lot of aha moments, when I say, hey, why don't you try tequila in your Bloody Mary? And they go, aha. And they say, and then their mind starts marinating. Well, you know, I like tequila like Bloody Marys. Why don't I try that? But there's a name for it. It's called Bloody Maria.
Ah, Bloody Maria.
Yes.
That makes sense.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
We move on to a gin, and as you can see, I'm sort of showcasing products that are, you know, want to be the next big brand, like the Murphs. So gin inside of your Bloody Mary, again, very nicely designed, is called the Red Snapper.
Okay.
Okay. Boom, boom. Moving on. This is a whiskey, a very delicious whiskey, very nicely packaged. Whiskey in a Bloody Mary is called a Bloody Jack.
A Bloody Jack.
Yes. Okay, and finally, and this is sort of the...
Wait, I think I might know what this one is, right? I think I do. I want to call it, I remembered it by thinking Michelangelo, but it's a Mica something.
Close,
okay.
close. Look at the ceiling, Michelada.
A Michelada, okay, it's a Michelada, okay. So this is a Michelada.
Yes,
and that's
delicious.
Made with?
That's made with spicy tomato juice, preferably Bloody Mary, Murphs, of course. Mm-hmm. And any kind of craft beer or any sort of traditional beer that you may drink. That's why I featured either an IPA or in that case, because you know why I came with a Corona? Because it's very, very popular in the Southeast. A lot of people in Mexico and Texas drink
this
because they like spicy. They like beer and they like spicy. So
it smells so good.
Yes. So they created the Michelada, but it's sort of coming in this direction. You'll see a lot of people in the Northeast and the Southeast and the Midwest drinking them now.
So any palate. You can go to Amazon now, which is so good.
Yes.
Congratulations on that.
Oh, thank
because
you.
I knew you when you were just like selling it out of the trunk of your car.
Yeah, yeah true.
Now he's everywhere. So
we have the Murph Party in a Box, which comes with the Murph original and hot and spicy. Okay.
Nice.
You can order it on Amazon. It comes with our pepperoncinis included in the box. So it's party.
Those are good too.
I know they're delicious, right? Party in a Box. What I love about the Party in a Box, Donna, is the recipes that you made mention of are on the back of the label.
It really is. It's great for hot wings. It's great for pizza. It's great in meatloaf. So any of the traditional ways that you'd be cooking at home, you add a little of this, you add a little of that, add the Murphs.
Yeah, add the Murphs. That's what I'm saying. Sooner or later, it's going to resonate.
It is going to resonate. It's going to resonate.
You know, my original plan in the backseat of the car was to make Bloody Marys exciting and give it personality.
Mm-hmm.
And obviously come to the market with a really, really premium product. So I think I've done that. And I like to plant in the consumer's brain, the customer's brain, that, wow, I can use Murph for just more than Bloody Marys. I can
have
Bloody Maria, Red Snapper. I can cook and marinate with it. So
it's a nice gift too. I cannot tell you how many people have come to my Memorial Day parties throughout the years, and we always have the Murphs there. And then people are like, what is that?
Yeah.
And I'm like, well, you could get it here. I said, plus he's my friend.
Yeah.
So it's really good.
Yes.
So congratulations
on
continued success to you for launching a huge, gigantic brand.
It's fun. It's fun to promote. And you get to do things like this.
You get to hang out with me and hang out with you at home. So if this is something that interests you, please check it out. I highly endorse it. And you know, I'm not going to endorse anything that I don't myself truly enjoy. And I do enjoy the Murphs. Stay tuned. We've been living it up right here.